Welcome to the video series lectures on artificial neural networks. Today, in the first lecture, we will introduce the artificial neural network, means we will go through the introduction of the artificial neural networks in detail. Basically, whatever the work which is being done on neural networks is the artificial neural network. As the name suggests, that there is a neural network means it is being related to the human brain. And whatever the work which is being done on the neural networks, the suffix is being added, that is the artificial neural networks. So let us start with the introduction of artificial neural networks. As I already told that neural networks are related to the human brain, so let us start with that. Ever imagine how our brain work? What is exactly inside the brain which is working for us? Basically, it was more than 2000 years ago that our ancestor has started to discover the architecture and behavior of human brain. Amongst them, Ramon and Hare continued the work of Aristotle and tried to build the artificial thinking machine. Now, based on the information about the functions of the brain and quest for obtaining a mathematical model for our learning habits, a new technology, artificial neural networks, was started. So initially, for the development of a processing machine and to mimic the human brain, a new technology is being started, that is the artificial neural networks. Now, our brain can process information quickly and accurately. For an example, you can recognize your friend's voice in a noisy railway station. If we consider our brain as one of the recognition systems, or it's working as a recognition system, so in this example, our brain can manage to recognize a familiar voice in a moment of time, along with the noise which is being associated to that. For a computer to mimic the same task, it will take time which is much more than the human brain. It may be in hours also. If you take an example of a computer to do the same task, then we need to feed the inputs to the computer, and the computer is going to learn from the inputs, that after comparing the input with the inbuilt voices, the computer will compare and then came to a conclusion that this voice is having a match with this particular voice. So, depending on this, some question arises, like how the brain able to process the voice signal added with the noise and retry the original signal. Amazing, isn't it? Can we duplicate this amazing process through a machine? Can we make a machine to duplicate some learning habits of a human? Or can a machine be made to learn from experience like we do as human beings? So in the following sections, we reveal the answers to these questions. So let us start with, what is a neural network? Now, an artificial neural network is nothing but an information processing system that has been developed as a generalization of the mathematical model of human cognition. Cognition means the acquisition of the knowledge through thoughts. So artificial neural network is nothing but an information processing system which is being developed to mimic the working or the functionality of the human brain, or we can say that for the generalization of the mathematical model of the human cognition or the knowledge faculty. So to understand the artificial neural network or the functioning of the artificial neural network, we must first understand the neural network. So a neural network is a network of interconnected neurons inspired from the studies of the biological nervous system. So neurons are the part of human brain, and the interconnection between the neurons will make a neural network. So in other words, the neural network functions in a way similar to the human brain. And the function of neural network is to produce an output pattern when presented with an input pattern. That is the functionality of a neural network. So, summing up all together, we will have a definition of neural network. That neural network is a study of network consisting of nodes connected by adaptable weights which store experimental knowledge from task examples through a process of learning. So neural network is nothing but a study of networks, and that network comprising of nodes. The connection between the nodes is being made in a way that some weights is being provided to that connection. Now see that the nodes of the brain are adaptable. They acquire knowledge through changes in the node weights by being exposed to samples. Our brain is adaptable. We can adapt so many things depending on our experiences. So we acquire the knowledge through changes in the node weights, so that weights, that information which is being provided to the neurons by being exposed to the samples. So to understand the artificial neural network, let us start with the original neural network, that is the brain. Now the neural network architectures are motivated by models of the human brain and nerve cells. Means if we are going to learn the functionality of an artificial neural network, and if we are going to learn the architecture of an artificial neural network, then we need to go through the similarity between the brain, that is the original neural network, and then we can compare the original neural network with the artificial neural network. But whatever we know regarding the brain is limited to its anatomical and physiological information that we have. Now, as far as the word neural or neuron is concerned, it is a Greek word whose meaning is nerve cell, as our brain is made up of nerve cells. That is the fundamental unit of the brain. The neuron is a complex biochemical and electrical signal processing unit that receives and combines signals from many other neurons through filamentary input paths. These filamentary input paths are known as dendrites. That is a Greek word whose literal meaning is tree lines. So neurons get the signals from the tree like or tree lines structure inside the brain, that is dendrites. This is a biological nerve cell or a neuron in the human brain. Now, that is being made up of these three lines. These three lines are being known as dendrites. So whatever the other neurons, they will communicate with the dendrites of the other nerve cell. We are having, so this will be the input part of the nerve cell. In the same way, we are having the output part of the nerve cell also, that is axon. So we are having dendrites as an input part, axon as an output part. So incoming axons from other neurons will communicate with the dendrites. So that is a biological nerve cell. So basically, these two components we are seeing, that is dendrites and axon. There is one more component which is being known as soma. So dendrites are bunched into highly complex dendritic trees which have an enormous total surface area. And as I already told that this dendritic trees are being connected to another neurons and it will receive the signal from the other neurons. So the dendritic trees are connected with the main body of the neuron called the soma. The Greek word is the soma, the meaning is body. So the soma has a pyramidal or cylindrical shape. What exactly the soma will do? The soma sums the incoming signals. Whatever the incoming signals that will come, the summation of the incoming signal is being done by the soma. When the sufficient input is received, the cell fires. This line means that when the signal is being generated by a neuron, so when a sufficient input is received, only then the cell will fire and it will provide signal to the other neuron. The output area of the neuron is a long fiber called axon. The impulses signal triggered by the cells is transmitted over axon to other cells. So from axon, whatever the output signal that is being transmitted to other nerve cells into the brain. Now see that this connecting point between a neuron's axon and another neuron's dendrite is called a synapse. Synapse is a Greek word whose meaning is contact. Means how they are being connected. So they are being connected by means of a synapse. Now the impulse signals are then transmitted across a synaptic gap by means of a chemical process And a single neuron may have 1,000 to 10,000 synapses and may be connected with around 1,000 neurons. There are 100 billion neurons in our brain, and each neuron has 1,000 dendrites. Means there will be trillions of synapses that we have in a human brain. If we see the functionality of a human brain, then a human brain is a highly complex. It is a parallel processing system as well as a non-linear system. Most of the neurons are being connected parallelly to the other neurons. Because of this parallel connections, the processing speed of the human brain is much more larger than that of the traditional computers that we use as a processing system. So that is the basic comparison between a brain, that how actually a brain will work, that it is a parallel, highly complex and non-linear system in comparison to the computers. So the processing speed of the brain is very high in comparison to the traditional computers, which are being used as a processing units. Now see that after going through the neural network, the original neural network, let us define an artificial neuron. Now see that this artificial neuron, also called processing element or neuron, which is going to mimic the characteristics of the biological neuron that we had studied. The processing element possesses a local memory and carries out localized information processing operation. So, for an artificial processing element, a memory is being required. So, in a memory, whatever the processes which are to be processed are to be stored, or the information which is to be processed are to be stored, and then the processing operations are being performed. So, if we want to model an artificial neuron, then we are supposed to think about a set of n inputs. Means to an artificial neuron, there will be a set of n inputs. So that will be xi, each representing the output of another neuron, where the subscript I can take the value between 1 and n and indicates the source of the vector input signal, means the input part, and collectively we can say the input is x, and the value of x can be from, that is from 1 to n. Now see that every input must be given an appropriate information for the problem. Only then that particular problem is being solved by the artificial neuron. So that is nothing but the weight. So each input is weighed before it reaches the main body of the processing element. By the connection strength or the weight factor or simply weight, analogous to the synaptic strength. So the synaptic strength in the original neural network is analogous to the weight in the artificial neuron. The amount of information about the input that is required to solve the problem is stored in form of waves. So whatever the inputs which are being given to an artificial neuron, it must have the information. So a particular problem statement must be solved. So that is nothing but the waves that is being provided to the each input. This each signal is multiplied with an associated weight, that is W1, W2, W3 till Wn, before it is applied to the summing block. Okay, so whatever the input signal that is being multiplied with the associated weight before we can apply it to the summing block. Now, in addition, the artificial neuron has a bias term W0, a threshold value theta that has to be reached or extended for a neuron to produce a signal. As we have seen, for an original neuron, when it will fire. In the same way, for an artificial neuron, it is having this threshold value theta that has to be reached, only then the neuron will produce a signal. And a non-linear function f that acts on the produced signal, that produced signal is net, and an output y after the non-linearity function. So that basic model of neuron is shown in the figure. And it should be noted that the input to the BIOS neuron is assumed to be 1. Now see that this is the basic neuron model. In this basic neuron model, these are the inputs x0, x1, x2, x3 and xn. To the x0 input, we are assuming it is 1. So we are taking it is w0. And then we are having the inputs x1, x2, x3, xn, which is being multiplied by the weights w1, w2, w3 till wn. That is being summed up by a summing block. So we get a signal that is net, and a non-linearity function is being applied to this summed signal, and finally we will get the output y. That is a very basic neural model. Now, the following relations describes the transfer functions of a basic neural model. So, we are having the output y is the non-linearity function f of the summed signal, that is net. Where this net, the summed signal is equal to, that is the w0 plus x1 w1 plus x2 w2 plus x3 w3 plus xn w till the nth n. Or you can write in another way also, that a net is equal to w0 plus sigma I is equal to 1 to n, that is your xi w1, where the value of I is between 1 to n. And the neuron firing condition is, means when a neuron will generate a signal, that is sigma I is equal to 0 to n, xi wi must be greater than equal to theta for linear activation function, and we are considering x0 is equal to 1. And for non-linear activation function, this f net must be greater than equal to theta, only then the neuron will generate a signal. So that is the neuron firing conditions. So after going through the artificial neuron, let us start with the classification of artificial neural networks. So it can be classified on the basis of the architecture of the network, means the pattern of connection between the neurons, that how exactly the neurons are being connected to each other. The second classification is the activation function applied to the neurons. That which kind of activation function is being applied to the neuron. And the third classification is the training or the learning method. Means the method of determining weights on the connection. Then how a particular network is being trained, or the learning method which is being employed by that particular system, or the method by which the weights on the connection is being determined. So these are the three classifications. Let us start with the first classification, that is the architecture of a neural network. Basically, the architecture of a neural network comprising of how a particular neuron is connected to the other neurons to make a network. So the neurons are assumed to be arranged in layers, and the neurons in the same layer behave in the same way. Means they are being interconnected. So we are assuming that the neurons are arranged in layers, and in a particular layer they will behave as the same. All the neurons in the layer usually have the same activation function. The activation function in a layer will not change. It will be the same activation function. Within each layer, the neurons are either fully interconnected or not connected at all. The neurons in one layer can be connected to neurons in another layer. So the arrangement of neurons into layers and the connection pattern within and between layers is known as network architecture. That is the definition of a network architecture. So basically, the architecture of a neural network comprising of an input layer, that is on the input side. So the neurons in this layer receive external input signals and perform no computation, but simply transfers the input signal to the neurons in the another layer. That is the input layer. The next layer in the architecture of neural network is the output layer, from where the input layer will send the information to the output layer. So neurons in this layer receive signals from the neurons either in the input layer or in the hidden layer. And in between the input layer and output layer, there is a hidden layer. So basically, the neural nets or neural networks are often classified as single layer networks or multi-layer networks. They are being classified into two type of networks, that is a single layer networks and a multi layer networks. So this number of layers in a net can be defined as the number of layers of weighted interconnection links between the various layers. That how many weighted interconnections are in between the input layer and output layer. Depending on that, they are being called as single layer networks and a multi layer networks. The input layer is not being counted for the computation of the number of layers in a neural network. Okay, so let us see the architecture of single layer and multi layer neural networks. Now see that in a single layer neural network, this one is a single layer neural network, in that these are the inputs that we are having: x1, xi, xn. These are the inputs, and in a single layer the number of weighted layer is only one. That's why it is a single layer. And we are having the output in terms of y1, yj and yn. So this weighted connections, the interconnection between the input and output with this wave is being written as, like, for this line it will be W11. In the same way, for this line it will be WI and then 1. Is it clear? So only one weighted layer, so that's why a single layer neural net. In the same way, for a multi-layer neural network, these are the inputs, so this is not to be counted. So in between, we are having more than one weighted layers, U and V, between X as inputs and Y as output layer. So this one is the hidden layer. This one is the hidden layer. So because of more than one weighted layers, this is being known as a multi-layer neural network. Now see that this single layer neural network can be used for pattern classification problems. So what are the pattern classification problems? They can be handled by a single layer neural network, and a multi-layer net with non-linear activation function can solve any type of problem. So normally, to solve any kind of problems using an artificial neural network, a multi-layer neural network is being used. But training a multi-layer neural network is very difficult. So this is the thing which is to be overcome. So that is all about the architecture of a neural network. So after going through the architecture of the neural network, let us go with the next thing, that is the activation function. Now, the purpose of non-linear functions is to ensure that the neuron's response is bounded. Means we are providing non-linear functions to a neuron to bound the output or the neuron's response. So the actual response of the neuron is conditioned or damped as a result of large or small activating stimuli and thus controllable. So it will be controllable or it will be smoother. So in order to achieve the advantages of multi-layer nets compared with the limited capabilities of single-layer networks, non-linear functions are required. So different non-linear functions are used depending upon the paradigm and the algorithm used for training the network. Okay, so there are different non-linear functions which are being used to train the network. So let us go with this different activation functions. The first activation function is the identity function. It is a linear function which can be expressed as fx is equal to x for all value of x, and the identity function will be represented by this curve. So on the x-axis you are having x, on y-axis you are having fx, and fx will have all the values of x from this curve. The next activation function is a binary step function. So it can be defined as fx, as it is binary, so it will have two values. One if x is greater than or equal to theta, and zero if x is less than theta. So that can be graphically represented as, so there is fx. So for fx, value is 1 for greater than theta. So if we define theta over here, so its value is 1 if x is greater than equal to theta, and below that value its value is 0. Okay, so that is a binary step function. Then we are having a sigmoid function which can be expressed as fx is equal to 1 upon 1 plus e raised to minus x, and graphically it will be represented by this graph. So we are having x between minus 5, 0 to 5, and by putting this value in this equation you will get the value of fx. So this is the graphical representation of a sigmoidal or a logistic function. In the same way, we are having a bipolar sigmoid function. It is the activation function which is being used when the desired range of output value is between minus 1 and plus 1. It can be expressed as fx is equal to 2 upon 1 plus e raised to minus x minus 1. And this is the graphical representation of fx from this expression. So the output range is between minus 1 and plus 1. So that is a bipolar sigmoid function. So after going through the all activation functions, let us solve one example for the better understanding of the concepts. So in this example, a neural network is being given. So in this we are having inputs x1, x2, x3, x4, and to these inputs are being given 0.8, 0.3, 0.2, 0.6. Weights are being given minus 0.2, 0.3, 0.8, 0.5. They all are being summed over here along with this another input, that is our x0, that we are assuming it as 1, and the weight to this input is 0.25, as we had seen in the model of an artificial neuron. And finally we will get this output y. So for the given network, find the output of the neuron y when the activation function is, that is, binary sigmoidal, and we are supposed to find for bipolar sigmoidal also. So how actually we are supposed to proceed? So in the solution, now see that as in the artificial neural model we have seen that the net input to neuron y is nothing but the summation of the product of the input and the weight. So all the inputs and the weights are being multiplied and summed together, so we will get y in. So y in is being found first. As you can see over there, that we will find y in first. So that will be nothing but the multiplication of the input with the weight, and we will do the summation as we have seen the summing block in the artificial neuron. So these all things will be summed together. So finally we will get y in is equal to 0.64. So for binary sigmoidal activation function, we know that y is equal to f of y in. So that is nothing but 1 upon 1 plus e raised to minus x. So we are just putting the value of y in over here. Okay. So that is 1 plus e raised to minus 0.64. So we will get the answer 0.654. In the same way, for bipolar sigmoidal activation function, while putting the expression, we will get the result 0.309. So this is how we can find the activation function. That is for a binary sigmoidal activation function and for a bipolar sigmoidal activation function. So this is all we have for today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will start with the third classification, that is the learning or teaching method, and then we will go for the classification in much more detail, the applications of the neural network in much more detail, and then we will conclude the introductory chapter by comparing an artificial neural network with a biological neural. So for today's lecture, we are having only this much. Thank you very much.